Because these are the days that you see that Satan is not hiding anymore, but yet Christians are not seeing Satan. Yet the preachers, yet those that call themselves that they are saved, they are believers, they don't see Satan, and yet Satan is not hiding. We are in the end time days. Satan is not hiding himself. Satan has revealed himself. You see, the Antichrist is revealing himself, but yet you don't see because of the eyes. The eyes of the heart has not opened. And so you cannot see. Many of the churches in this hour, they are serving the devil in the name of Jesus. They are serving the devil, saying that they are worshiping Jesus. They are serving and worshiping the devil, saying that they are worshiping God, where they are worshiping the God of darkness, but not God. They are jumping and saying they have been filled by the Holy Spirit. Other people even speaking in tongue, but they are not speaking from the Spirit of God, but the spirit, the unclean spirit. There is unclean spirit. Those unclean spirit are there, and they are performing signs and miracles. The Bible says in the book of Revelation, then I saw the three spirits that came out of the mouth of that beast, and that evil spirit, they looked like a frog. And the Bible says that they are the spirit. They are the spirit that perform for miracles. The spirit of the false prophet that used to perform signs and miracles. So you see that there is unclean spirit that has entered in the church. And that unclean spirit is performing signs and miracles. But they are worshipping the devil. But they are worshipping in the name of Jesus. Satan has been baptized. Satan has been changed the name and has been called Satan. Has been called God today. Has been called Jesus today. Like so there was Jesus. There were many Jesus. So today there's many Jesus. Satan has also his name like Jesus, and they are performing miracles through that name. They are doing miracles through that name, and they are living. They are full of devil. They are full of like hell. They are living an unclean life, a life of sexual sin, a life of immorality, a life of homosexuality in that church, a life of adultery, a life of drunkenness, a life of unclean, a life of greediness of money, a life of greediness and rusting. What an abomination hour that we are living. When the church is full of unclean, the church is worshipping the devil in Jesus' name. They are worshipping. They are doing. They are performing. They are all saying the false prophet is using the same Bible to preach, but he's a false prophet. What a time that we are living as a church in this hour. God is saying there is a true church. That one church is filled of the Holy Spirit. Know where you are. Because if where you are, you may be sitting in the church that is filled of the unclean spirit. Those spirits, the demonic spirit that God is saying that she has become a home of demons. Demons preaching in the church. Demons evangelizing in the church. Demons singing. Demons worshipping. Demons have taken charge. Has taken control in the church. Demons speaking out of the preacher. Look. We are in the time of deception, the time of the end times, when God is saying that there will be deceiving spirit that will come to deceive people. And the doctrines of demons that will be increasing in this hour. People are preaching with the doctrines of demons. Doctrine inspired by by demons will be speaking. This is the hour that we need to know the truth and to be separate, because the hour has come. We are in the evil days, when the spirit of bad in the church. And when that spirit is there, when unclean spirit is there, the church is in darkness. And there is no right. There is not the gospel of righteousness. There is not the gospel of holiness. There is no gospel of repentance. There is no rebuking sin. And the church has become like entertainment. Like entertainment in the church, like a comedy in the church. Preacher preaching with full of entertainment, full of laughing, full of cracking jokes in the church. The church has become a home for unclean demons. All demons are there, and unclean spirit, they are full there. Because they have left the holiness of God. The sermons of holiness, the sermon of righteousness has been forgotten right now. They are no more preaching the sermon of the gospel of God. They're no more preaching the gospel of the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord is not the church. The gospel of righteousness is not the church. They have forgotten the gospel of God. Why? Why are we living in such a condition of the world? In such a condition of the church? We have ignored the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit kept on saying, repent the church. Repent, come back to righteousness. Come back to holiness. Come back to the fear of God. Come back to the repentance. The Spirit of God has been speaking to the church, to the preachers, to the apostles, to the prophets, to humble themselves. They have lifted themselves like gods. They want to be worshipped. They want to be called every greatest name, every mightiest name. The unclean spirit has entered them. And now the spirit of pride has taken control, and all glory, all worship is giving is given to man, is going to man. Let us fear God. The unclean spirit is at work, and those three frogs that were sent out, they are the spirits of the false prophet that perform miracles and signs. They will do everything. They will even resurrect this beast, for that beast was given power to give breath to another beast. It is written, it is in the word of God, the powers that are used, they will be used to deceive the elected if possible, but they will not. So the Bible says that because of those days shall be shortened because of the elected. For if it were not so, no one would be saved. These are the days when people are worshipping in the church, but worshipping with the demons. Worshipping with the possessed spirit. You are worshipping, you are preaching. Preachers are preaching, but they are preaching where they have demons. Some of the people you see preaching, they are preaching not because of God of the Holy Spirit, but they are preaching out of the unclean spirit, out of demons. They need deliverance. Some of the prophets, they need deliverance. Some of the pastors, some of the evangelists, apostles, they need deliverance. It is demons that are speaking inside them, speaking and preaching and using the Bible. The Bible does not matter. Even a possessed man can speak with the Bible, can hold the Bible. The Bible does not have power. The power is in the word of God. The power is in those that have the spirit of the Lord. So anyone can use the Bible. Even the Satanism, they are using this Bible. The many of them, they are the ones that are even producing the Bibles, the many Bibles that we are using today. Why? Because everything can happen in this hour. He is calling a church of Holy Spirit, not a church of unclean spirit and demonic spirit. This is the time to be told the truth, because you are running for the signs and miracles where the unclean spirit are performing miracles. That is where you are running. Running even to witchcraft, running even to Satanism because of miracles. Those miracles are what you are seeking, but you are not seekers of the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is near. Choose between where you want. For God is saying that today the churches has been defiled and the unclean spirit has entered in the church. The unclean spirit in the church. The women are dressing like harlot, like prostitute. Men are dressing like harlot, like prostitute also. Tight clothes that are revealing their body shape. Seducing women. Women seducing men. You see, there are a lot of sexual sin in the church. Masturbation in the church, abortion in the church, sin. The church has become of unclean spirit. The fruit that you see with the church, Christianity, is the evidence of the unclean spirit in the church, of the demons in the church. And this is the hour to be awakened. Because if you will not be awakened with this message, you will be awakened by tribulation. When God called the apostles, the pastors, the prophets, the teachers, and the evangelists, when God called the fivefold office, he called them to prepare the bride of Christ. He called them to prepare and to mature the bride of Christ for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But are you preparing the bride of Christ today? Preachers, prophet, evangelist, apostles, you, are you preparing the bride of Christ? Because the calling of God, the meaning, the mission, the mandate for the preacher is to prepare the church of God for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. You are very comfortable preparing how they will build, preparing them for this world, but not for the kingdom of God. For you are of this kingdom. You are of this world, not of heaven. For the Bible says that whoever comes from heaven, he preaches the things of heaven. But he who comes from this earth, he preaches the things of this earth. You see? So there is a difference when you hear those people that are preaching the things of this world. Because they belong to here. They are sons of the devil. They are serpent they are children of vipers. They are people that John said, you blood of vipers, who have warned you to run away from the love of God.